Hello everybody, my name is Vinay Jacob John. Please visit my three gospel websites, JesusHealsMinistries.org, PrayInTongues.org, and also PeopleOfJesus.org. Today we are going to read about giving and receiving in the name of Jesus Christ. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. Give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. Acts chapter 20, verse 32. And now, brethren, I commend you to God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, and to the word of his grace, Jesus' grace, which is able to build us up and to give us an inheritance among all of us who are sanctified by the blood of Jesus. Verse 33, I have coveted no man's silver or gold or apparel. Verse 34, yea, ye yourselves know that these hands have ministered unto my necessities and to them that were with me. I have showed you all things, how that so laboring ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, how Jesus said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Verse 36, and when he had thus spoken, he knelt down and prayed with them all. Second Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9. For ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though Jesus was rich, yet for our sakes Jesus became poor, that we through Jesus' poverty might be rich. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6. But this I say, he which soweth sparingly will reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity. For our God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, loves a cheerful giver. Verse 8, and God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, is able to make all grace abound toward you, that he, always having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. Verse 9, as it is written, he has dispersed abroad, he has given to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. Verse 10, now he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food, and multiply your seed sown, and increase the fruits of your righteousness. Philippians chapter 4, verse 10, but I rejoice in the Lord Jesus greatly, that now at the last your care for me has flourished again, wherein ye were also careful, but ye lacked opportunity. Not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatever state I am therewith to be content. I know both how to be abased and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. Verse 13, I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. Notwithstanding, ye have done well that ye did communicate my affliction. Now you Philippians know also that in the beginning of the gospel, when I departed from Macedonia, no church communicated with me as concerning giving and receiving, but you only. Verse 16, for even in Thessalonica you sent once and again unto my necessity, not because I desire a gift, but I desire fruit that may abound to your account. Verse 18, but I have all and abound, I am full, having received of Epaphroditus the things which were sent from you, an odor of a sweet smell, a sacrifice, acceptable, well-pleasing to God. Verse 19, but my God, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, shall supply all your needs according to Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit's riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Verse 20, now unto God our Father, Jehovah Jesus, and the Holy Spirit be glory forever and ever. Amen. Thank you all for listening to me today. Jesus loves us all. Jesus heals us all. Jesus provides for us all. Always. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.